Stanford University.
We have observational seismologists. We have people looking at ground deformation before and after earthquakes. We have people like myself doing the earthquake physics and modeling. It really forms a very nice community.
I and most of my students are seismologists. We use seismic waves to image the Earth, to interrogate what is inside the Earth. It's a form of remote sensing. We can use the waves from distant earthquakes, or the waves that we make with small controlled sources, releasing compressed air, for example, at sea, to image what is beneath our feet. My students have worked with colleagues in India to image what we call the main Himalayan thrust. That's the subduction zone along which India is diving beneath the Himalaya in Tibet, being dragged down into the mantle. And that's the earthquake fault that has one of the greatest hazard potentials on Earth.
What we did was develop a new approach, which we call the virtual earthquake approach. Now, the virtual earthquake approach uses what we call the ambient seismic field, which are the waves that are present in the Earth at all times. Those waves, even though they're billions of times weaker than earthquake waves, they interact with the complex geologic structure of the crust in just the same way. It's a new way of testing these sort of simulations, and that's the information that we use to characterize the hazard, and also that's the information that the engineers use to design structures.
Following the 2011 Tohoku earthquake, it was the large earthquake in Japan that created the damaging tsunami. We've generalized our earthquake simulations to also include gravitational restoring forces, and what that does is it gives us the capability to also model the tsunami generation process. So now we have the computational tool that we can use to investigate earthquakes like the Tohoku earthquake. We can calculate the seismic waves, the ocean acoustic waves, as well as the tsunamis, and look for relations between those types of waves.
For more, please visit us at stanford.edu.